Hey everybody, welcome to the day of fast feast. I was feeling like something heavy and filling, decided on some shepherd's pie, something that'll stick to the ribs, be great for the cold. So here's the ingredients: olive oil, medium onion, mushrooms, carrots, celery, peas, garlic, flour, water or broth, salt, rosemary, potatoes, milk, and pepper. Sounds like a lot, but you have most of it already in your house. Starting with some potatoes, no big deal, slice them up, cube them up, you want nice big chunks. After that, you're gonna put a pot of water onto the stove, salt, potatoes. While that's boiling, get the rest of your ingredients ready. You'll need the frozen peas, chop up your mushrooms in nice big pieces, celery, carrots, onion, sliced, garlic, grated. You'll know that your potatoes are ready when they're fork tender. You should be able to pierce it right through, just like that. Drain your potatoes, and if you don't have milk, you can reserve some potato water, and you can use that to mash the potatoes. I'm going to be using unsweetened almond milk. So put the potatoes back in the pot, add some of the garlic that you grated, and mash it up. If you don't have a potato masher, that's fine. You can use a fork. Then add some salt to taste, and then add your milk, but be warned. Make sure that you don't add too much milk like I did. You want a mashed potato, not like a creamed potato, which is what I ended up with. So it made it a little difficult to top the pie in the end. Next up, you put your potatoes aside. Get a large saucepan. I'm using my Dutch oven. About a tablespoon of olive oil. It should be nice and hot. And you put your onions in, just the onions to start with. Nice and sizzling. It smelled really good at this point too. And you're gonna cook it till it's translucent. Break up any chunks that are still together. You're gonna add your mushrooms to this, and you're gonna let that cook until they start to lose some of the moisture. After that, you add your carrots and your celery. You're also gonna add your peas and the rest of your garlic. Now this is gonna take a little more time to cook because you want a lot of the water to cook off. Not all of it, just most of it. Mix it all up, make sure all of the garlic is well spread out. You don't want chunks of garlic. When you get to the point where most of the water is cooked off, we add our thickener, which is cornstarch. I think I had about 2 tablespoons. Mix it up so you don't have any chunks of cornstarch anywhere in the dish, and let it sit and let it cook down. After that, add your water. But I kind of overdid it. The recipe requires 3 cups of water or broth. I did that, but then I ended up with something that looked like drowned vegetables. And then even seeing that, I added more. I would recommend maybe about 1 or 2 cups, but add to your taste. I also added in about 1/2 cup of lentils, which I think complements the flavor. Very earthy and gives the food even more bite, along with the mushrooms, and just let it cook down. Here it's cooked down a good bit. I don't know if you can tell, it has a little shine to it. It looks more like a gravy, so it thickened really nicely. Still a little watery, but going forward anyway. I'm adding everything into my casserole dish. You can use individual containers if you want. It's totally up to you, but since there's so much, I decided to use a large container. You also want to make sure that you preheated your oven. It's okay if you haven't, but you want to do that in advance. And now we're placing the potatoes, which was a touch difficult because it started to like sink in, and I was hesitant to continue, but I was like, I've come this far, can't waste it. So after a little while, I got most of it covered, and after letting it bake for a little while, I turned out with this, which wasn't so bad. It tasted pretty good, and the layer was nice and firm. It wasn't soft. No liquid was oozing through. So the shepherd's pie, really good. Simple ingredients, simple prep, satisfying, but time-consuming. You gotta really prep those ingredients in advance. I give it a 3. Definitely would do it again, but not that many times. Thanks for watching, and check the description box below for more information about the videos.